There's no player in the NBA right now who played high school basketball in Canada. I'm hoping that I'm going to start a steady stream of players from Canada into the NBA.
Spread your legs apart a little bit more. Put shoulder width and you have good
balance. See? It's just a matter of getting them on the right track and really having someone to look up to and follow their path. I always thought I could make the NBA. It's a dream come true, which is amazing because how many people actually have their dreams come true?
The Phoenix Suns select Steve Nash from the University of Santa Clara.
I know they have a great organization. I think that they have a really good team as well and good people out there. You know, I'm going to try to learn a lot at first, especially having 2 point guards there right now. And, you know, those are really great guards. I love an opportunity to learn under them.
Kid on the move. Kid up to KJ. It's a three. Yes!
I don't play because I'm not good enough. I'm not as good as Kevin Johnson right now or Jason Kidd. I know I just have to keep improving, and eventually, yeah, I will play a lot in this league.
This is a shot. Rebounded to Nash. Nash ahead to Kidd. Bounce it to KJ, who scores on the break.
Steve Nash with the great pass to Kidd. Kidd with the lead pass to KJ.
Steve Nash, boy, has he elevated his game. He's always shown that he has a great work ethic and a tremendous amount of potential.
Nash with Phillips underneath his chin, spins, goes to the hole. Very well done by the guy you used to call rookie.
Everyone knows how overstocked the Suns roster is. Every general manager they call, they want a package that includes Steve Nash.
There is some uncertainty. All I have to worry about is going out there every day and trying to improve and get better and just love what I do. That's the easy part, just come out and work hard and get better. And if I do that, everything will take care of itself.
The Suns' crowded backcourt led to Nash's trade to the Dallas Mavericks before the 1999-2000 season. He would join the Mavs along with a 7-foot rookie from Germany, Dirk Nowitzki.
We both came to a new city. We both lived in the same apartment complex, and we hung out. You know, we didn't really know anyone else, so we became friends.
I don't know if he could
I'm
be
pretty
a
much
player.
An all-rounder. I mean, I can pretty much play hockey to soccer, whatever, tennis.
Steve was huge for my development, really. We played horse, we played shooting games, we played one-on-one games. Just constantly working on our games together and kind of grew together.
Nash blows by Anderson. Oh, what a wraparound of Dirk!
Nash talks about three, keeps it alive like he had it on a yo-yo.
With their all-star duo, the Mavs became a perennial playoff team, and Nash truly blossomed as a leader.
We got 1 week left. We got to take care of it now. We got to build from tonight. The practice this week is better. Season starts better. We got to build now.
You know, we always thought, Steve and myself, we're going to be the core of this organization.
After another tough loss in the playoffs in 2004, the Mavericks decided to part ways with Nash, who would return to Phoenix as a free agent.
It hurt, you know, not to be wanted back. Thought that we were gonna, you know, play our careers out in Dallas and win a championship. But, you know, in many ways, we were left thinking, what could have been.
How's everybody doing? We excited? All right, welcome back. It's great for me to be back. My teammates and I have been working really hard. We think we're going to have a hell of a year.
Here's Nash to the front of the
Here's Dirk watching Steve come down the lane. Get inside. How did he hit that layup?
Come on, Doug. How does he make that?
He's our point guard. He just play off him. Steve come off screen and rolls. He's so versatile with his left and right hand passes to where he can hit guys open.
It's almost like a quarterback with a handoff to a running back.
I looked at the lineup Phoenix had. I felt like I'd be a great fit and that we could develop into a contender.
Now that's Nash's best.
You know, I dreamed of playing in the NBA. I dreamed of being an all-star, but never. The MVP was somewhere. It was in a different world.
Nash would thrive in Phoenix's unique up-tempo offense, winning back-to-back MVPs in 2005 and 2006.
I remember the day he was going to have the press conference for winning the second straight MVP award, and I went in the locker room beforehand, and I thought to myself, the odds that this guy from Canada, who didn't play basketball as his first sport, who didn't go to a major university, is the MVP of this basketball league. I mean, when you consider that, that's got to be 50 million to one.
Although Nash would pile up the personal accolades, the ultimate goal of winning a championship still eluded him.
You know, you got to be lucky and play on a great team that has health and a great chemistry and, you know, a lot of factors to win a championship.
Unfortunately for Nash and the Suns, they were never able to get out of the tough Western Conference.
There's no guarantees of anything, but to come this far and to put this much into a season definitely hurts.
Injuries began to take their toll on Nash. He would leave the Suns to join the Lakers, where he added some more accomplishments to his already stunning resume.
Here it is.
Right there.
Duncan, now Steve Nash's number 3 all-time assists in the NBA.
Although he never captured an NBA title in his career, Nash will leave behind an unbelievable legacy for himself and his country, something he hoped to accomplish when he entered the league in 1996.
I just look at it as an opportunity to sort of represent my country and allow kids to have that dream and that vision.
Canadian players go back to back at number 1.
Anything's possible and available for you to do. It's just a matter of what you have inside.